Yo, what is going on YouTube? It is OG and it has been a very long time, guys. I'm sorry. Anyways, we just finished the July monthly finals, I guess. And we're in the final. Well, we're gonna be going over the games. It's the finals versus Tribe Gaming. So I think this is our fourth time playing them in the monthly finals. They beat us twice. We beat them once. I think we're the only team to actually beat them in the monthly finals up to this point because they won like a lot of them. So shout out to Tribe. It was honestly one of the most competitive series I've ever played, so you guys are gonna enjoy it a lot. Let's get into the games. All right, guys, game number one. So the first set is gonna be Triple Dribble, and the bans are, I think we ban B and Sprout, and they ban Gene and Primo. I'm pretty sure that's it. So I'm gonna be on the bell against Zulan, and we got him backed up little bit. So Barley is really good for early control because you get the sustain gadget. You can see it healed me and Zar up there, and it just enables us to like kind of win our lanes a little easier. So Zulan's kind of backed up. It's not his fault. It's mainly from the Barley sustain and stuff. And Bobby's doing a really good job. So he's gonna take out Cory here, and Zar is also doing a good job on that end. So we're gonna pinch Zulan and Tyrant, and we're just gonna try going for something here because I do get a kill on Tyrant, and Bobby's there to take out Zulan. So I'm just gonna super it over to Zar and he's gonna put it in. I forgot how much talking it is in YouTube. anyways, so you guys will see that Tyrant is gonna be using the new Sandy gadget. It's really strong right now, but I think our comp is fairly decent into it for the most part. Zar just has to play his corners really well, and Zar is honestly, in my opinion, probably the best Stu that I've seen. Not just like North America, he's really good at Stu, guys. So we're really lucky that Zar can just be such a little crack on Stu and carry us. So we're getting a little backed up now because Bobby is lower on the Barley gadgets. I'm not sure if he has any left, but he's doing a good job just trading back on Cory. Cory is going to heal it up a lot faster though, and he does outrange Bobby. So as long as I don't go down here, it's okay that I'm getting backed up. And you know, this is bound to happen. Sandy's going to get a super, and we just kind of have to like tough it out. And we're going to get a really good pinch. You can see Tyrant does get the sleep off, but they aren't able to finish Zar off. And because he went down there, we're able to push up a little bit. So we're going to take out the Tick Head, and we just have to play it slow. There's 45 seconds left, and I think I have like all my traps left, or at least like two traps left. So we're just gonna stick it in the corner down there. You guys can see I'm just gonna like set up my traps around it. Zar's doing a really good job. He is almost gonna take out Zulan. Tyrant's just gonna be triggering my traps there, and it's like, okay, you got that one. Here's another one, I think. So yeah, I'm just gonna. It's 25 seconds left, so we know we just have to hold on at this point and just not get team wiped pretty much. So I'm gonna go around and flank because I don't really do too much from that position. So I am gonna go down. It's a good hit tick head from Cory there. But I did manage to get Zulan pretty low, and Bobby's gonna super the ball and just spam it out. And we are gonna take game one because of that. So it was really good. We used our early advantages really well, and we did get an early goal. So that's one thing that we have trouble capitalizing off of sometimes, but I think we did it really well in this game. All right, guys, game number two. So we're going for something completely different. I did not have a lot of fun this game. This is really rough matchup for Poco, but it's not really my job to do anything besides give Bobby heals and Zar heals. And you can see Bobby, he's gonna do his signature, run into three of them and die trying to get bats. So I do get marked there. I'm gonna go down either way. So it looks really slothy right now, and it is, honestly. That's like the type of game it is. But unfortunately, they do just score here. So he's gonna get in 560. So if we could have like got better death timers, I think we would have been okay there, but unfortunately we couldn't. So they're off to an early lead, and we're just gonna get really backed up. So Tyrant's gonna pop his super and get two of us. And I try keeping Bobby alive. The heal is there a little late, unfortunately, but we are just gonna kind of like panic and get the ball out and try getting into a corner, because once we get like a good team wipe with Mort, that's kind of what this comp revolves around. Zar is doing pretty good too on the Stu as well, so we're just kind of hanging on and maybe looking for a pick on someone. And I'm gonna heal Zar, he's going in a bit, but nothing's gonna really happen. They're just kind of like choking us out at this point, so it's really tough. And the Ems is a good pick. Mort does do well into Ems, but I think the Ems is pretty good into Stu overall. And Cory's gonna be on tick too, so Bobby is gonna almost get a kill there, and he did have his bats, but he chose to save it. So they're really close to scoring here. Zulan, Bobby saved his bats luckily, and Zulan's gonna hit it off the wall, unfortunately. And, I mean, fortunately for us, unfortunately for them, but I think he probably could have scored there if he walked it in because Bobby is low, but I don't know, it would have been close. So we kind of managed to get out of that pretty luckily, I think. They've just been putting on so much pressure and doing a really good job this game. So I do manage to get my super, and I need to stay alive here because I can tell Bobby wants to go in, like we're talking in BC, like go in and stuff, and I get my heal off and he's gonna go for Tyrant and it's gonna be good. We get a kill, but unfortunately Zarr goes back, so we can't really capitalize on it too much. So I'm just trying to get my next super so I can help Bobby when he goes in. And you know, there's 30 seconds left, so you can see this game, we've been getting dominated, and Bobby's gonna get a really nice kill. I'm gonna pass it up to Bobby, and this is honestly the best goal I've ever seen Bobby VS score. I don't know who was playing for him there, but that was cracked. That was a really good goal. And I'm going to try getting my heal for overtime, but, you know, our comp was kind of iffy here. I definitely wouldn't play it again. And Zarr is going to get taken out, and we're going to get into the corner. I'm going to get taken out as well, and, you know, M's, fairly tanky brawler, going to pass it to Zarr. And, you know, they just do a good job moving the ball around, and we can't take it out at that point. So they do a good job, and they take game number two. Okay, guys, game number three. So the winner of this is going to take the first set. You always want to win the first set. Obviously, you want to win every set. But we knew they were going to stick with Bell, and we thought, like, something mid-range. And we thought, you know, Corey's been playing pretty good on Tick, so he'd stay with Tick. So we're going to go with Double Thrower here. And they're going to apply a lot of early pressure. And, you know, I got to shield the Tick head and try my best. Corey is... I think my Tick head made him panic. So definitely glad I put that Tick head out. And it's kind of, I don't know, like it looks like a big misplay, but there's a lot going on. You have to remember, this is like, it's easier to just analyze it. So they probably could have scored there, but I don't know, like there's a lot going on. You can't blame Corey too much. And you know, that kind of enables us, we get like our matchups right, which is important. I need to be on Bell because I do outrange her with my, like the top Tick mine. So I'm just gonna be trying to poke her down, you guys can see, and I'm just gonna trust that my teammates are gonna be able to do, you know, win their matchups mid and left lane as well. So I do get Zulan backed up. I did wanna use my Tick head to get position, that's why I decided to tank his Tick head, and I can just use my mines for that one. It was put in a fairly obvious spot. And here we want to score before overtime with this comp. Obviously we're Double Throwers, but if it does get into overtime, I don't think it's the end of the world just because they also have a Tick, and you know, Ems isn't the best overtime brawler, and we have long dash too. So the real threat in overtime is going to be Zulan on Bell, which is, he's definitely a very good Bell. And you can see he's doing a lot of work right now. He does get a good mark off on me. And the marks are very annoying. He can almost, well, he could two-shot me before, but he gets very close to one-shotting me. I think I get like 700 HP if he hits me. So I gotta be really careful. And Tyrant's pushing up a lot, but he is gonna overextend, and we're gonna get a kill, and that's gonna be a really big help to us. So I think that's a pretty big mistake there, because you can see because of that, I get to push Zulan back, and he's really low. Bobby gets a good super off, and Zulan's doing a really good job staying alive. Fortunately, I didn't know there was a trap there, but I think it's fine that I trade the kill with him, and because I was marked, right? So I want to get that mark off me if possible, and trading is like, you know, a good way to do it. So it's overtime now, so I think we're pretty decent in overtime because of long dash stew. Bobby's gonna take out Zulan, which is really big, and I think we're gonna pinch Corey back, and they're gonna use all their shots on my Tick head. Look at Zarr go, bro, what a little crack. And I just have to pass it to Bobby. He doesn't have enough ammo because of the new thing to kill Bobby, and Bobby's just gonna walk it in, and we are gonna take the first set. Alright guys, set number two. So we're on Canal Grande. Historically not one of our better maps, and I think this is definitely one of Tribe's better bounty maps. But Sprout is banned, which is nice. So me and Corey, it's gonna, just watch the left side. Me and Corey, it's gonna be really boring for a lot of this, and it's pretty much all onto the left side, like who wins that. So Zarr, what he was trying to do there was break the wall with his gadget and also hit Tyrant. But unfortunately, it just hit the wall and not Tyrant. So I think I'm kind of doing decent into Corey, but I shouldn't go up there. That's like a misplay for me. Because, you know, I see my left side is kind of losing. So I want to make something happen, and it just ends up putting us further behind. So it's a good job by Tyrant, just taking advantage of me going out of position. And the left side is just, they're clapping us right now. So this game's looking very grim, and I think the right thing to do is try coming through my side, which Czar is thinking about doing. So we're just spreading out so the bell doesn't hit us too much. And I have to push up because I don't want the tick to just spam us out. So I'm trying. I think I popped my gadget and I just decided to like push up really far. And I get Corey really low actually. So he popped his gadget. If not, it might kill him. I'm not sure. But I'm going to go up there and I kind of popped my gadget too late. But I still get some position. And Czar, look at this little crack, bro. Wait, okay, I've never replayed before, or like rewinded, but look at this. Just watch Czar. This guy just 1v2 so hard. Oh, that's such a good Brock sleeper. That's my first time seeing it. Czar is nuts, bro. What a little crack. So now we're only down by 2 stars, and I get the tick really low. Look at him wiggle too, bro. Czar was just playing out of his mind this set. I don't know what was going on. My tick head just goes completely around, and we get a kill. So, you know, Czar and Bobby, they kind of had a rough start to the match. But Czar just, like, popped off, bro. I don't know what was going on, but he just played very, very good. Like, he gets another one. He's going for 7 stars at this point. I think he gets core. Oh, he misses the super, but I think he's allowed to miss that after that. And, you know, me and Bobby, we're just going to, like, die so he can stay alive because he has blue star. You know, we're not that bad at math. We can see we'd still win, so we kind of just sacrifice ourselves. But Czar just played out of his mind that set. Alright guys, game number 2. So, I want us to have a better start. So I kind of changed my strategy. So I'll pinch, like, the left here, and it's like a stalemate. So any, like, shots that I hit, so I hit Zulan there, it's actually, like, a pretty big deal. So I want to make sure I don't get Corey, like, don't let him in the bush, but I am chipping down them. So I'll get Zulan low too. Czar's going to get a good super. And, you know, I've been getting a lot more shots than Corey has so far, and I'm just going to force myself in the bush. So unfortunately Bobby does go down, but he trades there and I can almost solo kill Corey here. He is gonna pop a gadget though, and you know, I did a pretty good job just backing him out there. On the other end, I think Czar is just feeling himself after that game. Look at him, bro. That's my little crack Czar, bro. And then we're gonna pinch Corey here because I'm calling out he's low, and I think, oh, that's so pain, but I'm gonna get tickhead and that should kill him, right? Okay, nice. So it does kill him and it gets out a gadget too. So I'm going to pinch here. Unfortunately, Czar, I think he gets... he's feeling himself a little too much. He almost kills Zulan though. And, you know, they are going to kill him. But he does get Tyrant on the way back. And he's going to get a really good super. Never mind, it didn't hit anyone. But it looked like it should hit at least one. So I don't know Tyrant's there. And then I think I go down. I should regen there. Yeah, I go down. I didn't know Tyrant was there. That's kind of my fault. I should have assumed he was coming up there. And we're just super backed up now. And pretty much, I want to stay on the tick. Because I think I was doing a pretty good job. Like, I got a solo kill pretty much. And I've been, like, keeping him pushed back. And so, I'm just going to rotate over. And because my long-range teammates have been outplaying them a bit this set. Besides the first game at the start. But since then, they've been pretty consistent. And, you know, we're just going to stay up. As long as we don't get team wiped, we are fine. And Bobby's going to go down. He'll get a kill. And we are going to take the bounty set. So, really, Czar was definitely the MVP of bounty. By far. Okay, guys. So, set number 3. We're up 2-0 in sets right now. So, we're feeling pretty good. I really like the comp they chose. So, they did Piper and Bell. So, Bobby's going to have a really rough game. So, I can tell him he's going to get curved right away. And you know, we do kind of trade, like, we don't get a kill on our side because Corey's playing a lot more passive, but Bobby is going to get taken out. And luckily for us, they did pick up that bolt, so we are going to get this one. But I think they still get it. Yeah, so they still get it, and we're going to get this one. But I think, like, I'm hitting some good shots, and I'm just trying to get my super, but I almost get it. I'm like one shot from it now, but Corey was just playing so passive and I was playing lane, right? So it was really hard for me to get my super, and obviously you want Bell super for defense. So I'm gonna push up, and me and Czar are gonna pinch Corey here, so we know he's there. It's a tough angle, but I can hit him if I aim it correctly. And Czar is just gonna, oh, okay, so nice dodge from Corey there. And you know, it's kind of like even, I guess. I don't want to get curved, so I have to back up here. And you know, Piper into Bell. I think I definitely favor Piper just because of the curves. I'm gonna take out Corey there. He hit my trap, but Bobby is gonna get on a trap, unfortunately, and we do tie, which is honestly really good because you know, defense, like, third bot wins pretty much. And I think Bobby should have lit up his oil there. But unfortunately, he does go down. And, you know, it's double long range into me, which is a little rough. I almost killed Zulan, though. He does hit my trap, and he's going to jump out. So if he didn't have jump there, I do kill him. And unfortunately, Bobby is going to go down again. Corey is going to do a good play. And I think Zar was calling for a pinch. I think I should have just focused more on mid there instead of trying to pinch Corey, because Corey did a really good play. But the Amber was definitely a really rough pick into this, I think. And it got pretty much no value. So I really like the comp that they play, and that's why we play it next game. So we are going to lose this one, and, you know, we can't win without any percent. But we're just going to, yeah, I'll mark it. We'll try our best, you know, but at the end of the day, you can't win without a bot. Or you can, I guess, but it's really hard to. And, you know, well played to them. I like their comp a lot. Alright guys, game number two. So I said I like their comp, and we are going to copy it. So Zar is going to go over there because he has a speed turret, and we want to get first. Does he use it? Yeah, okay. And then I'm going to have Corey on my side. So I do a pretty good job handling Corey. It's kind of hard with the speed turret and the angle, but you can see one shot and it's going to bounce off his turret. And Zar is going to do a really good job, and fortunately Bobby goes down, but I am able to take out Corey on my side, and we're going to get the first bot, I think. Yeah, so we get the first bot, but I think Bell did get super. Oh, wait, they don't even have a Bell. Never mind, I'm ignore that. But I'm just going to, like, focus on Corey, and they do have Barley Slow, which is really, really good on defense. And this map is just so defensive. It's, like, really hard. So here, Bobby's going to be mid. I'm going to be right lane. And I think I do a pretty good job of just keeping Corey at bay, but he does get a kill on me at some point. So I'm going to take out Corey there. Good pinch for me and Bobby. And, you know, we're just kind of dominating this game. We haven't let them get a bolt yet. And like I said, I think this comp's very good. And yeah, so I'm just going to keep holding down right side. Bell lane, it doesn't feel as good as Bell mid, but Corey's going to do a really good job here, and he's actually going to take me out and kill me. So I just should have backed off there. But Corey is going to kill me, which is really huge because I can do a lot of damage, obviously. So a really good play from Corey there. And, you know, we are going to get a lot of damage, but, you know, usually in Siege with the meta, third bot wins it. But this is a super defensive map, and if I can get my Bell super, I'm just going to hold on to it for the bot, and, you know, we should be able to just kind of melt it before it gets to our save. So I really want to make sure I get Bell super, but nobody's coming on my lane. Like, they're smart players, like, they're doing it on purpose. I want to see if we can get the bot at this point, but at this point, I realize it's kind of scuffed, so I just kind of go for Tyrant, because I see him, like, out of position a little bit, and I do manage to hit two shots and get my Bell super. So I also took out the Barley, or Bobby's gonna finish him off, I guess, but I got him pretty low, and that's gonna be really bad for their offense. And you can just see, like, before the Bell super is so broken on the bots, I don't know why they haven't changed it, but the bots aren't even gonna touch our safe, and I don't know if they touch our safe. I don't think they do. So yeah, we do manage to take them out, and we're gonna take game number two pretty convincingly. Alright guys, so the next map is, so it's game 3 on Factory Rush. Game point for us, if we do win this, then we do take the set. So you can see they brought out Ruffs, so it would counter Stu. But unfortunately, like, I'm doing a pretty good job on Ruffs. I do win my side here, and I'll take him out. So I do manage to get the kill because I had the shield star power. But unfortunately, the left side kind of lost, and you know, we are going to lose the first bot. If we got that first bolt, I think it would have changed the game a lot. But, you know, because we lost the left side, the dog is going to have time to kind of come online. And it's really hard to come out of spawn against a comp like this, especially for Zar because he gets outranged by everyone. And, you know, you can see I'm trying to push up. I'm pushing up into, like, some bags. So it's just really tough. And he's just going to keep putting them off spawn pretty much. And I'm going to hit him once or twice, but you can just see, like, it's really tough right here. And he's just going to keep putting bags. So I think the right call would be to just kind of, like, focus one side and hope we can push up to there. And I think the dog definitely has advantages because of the bounce shot there. But Zar is, unfortunately he doesn't get off. And, you know, we're not having a lot of fun this game. Dude, I'm trying to get my super. That's why I'm being so aggressive, because they can do so much damage here. They broke open the mid wall. We don't have Bell super for defense, and I think they could have 100% finished it here, but they decide to back out. I think 100%, if that's our team, we just go all in here. But they're playing, I mean, they don't think they need to risk it, which is, makes sense too. You know, they're powered up, they're holding position, but Bobby's gonna get two really good snipes in, and Zara's gonna hit all three traps, and we're holding down mid and left lane kinda. So I get Zulan low, and you know, we're gonna get it pretty close here. So unfortunately it's not gonna be enough though, and yeah, we are gonna lose. The Siege set, they played really well the last game. The Ruffs pick was really good. They know we've been playing a lot of Stew, so it's a good call for them to play Ruffs into it. So I'm just going to try killing Corey, because yeah, we play Wild Rift together. But he's going to kill me, unfortunately. And it's going to be 2-1 for us, but they are going to take the Siege set. All right, guys, set number 4 is going to be on Hot Zone. We're gonna go the same comp, triple long range, and we never I've never played Bell here really, so Bell right side was kind of new to me, and I feel like the Brock definitely has a big advantage just because he has walls to hide behind, and you can just see, like, I'm trying to be aggro, but he can just gadget me here, right? So I don't know if he sees my HP, but Zara's gonna do a really good job and kill Corey. So I feel like the Bell's definitely at a disadvantage in this lane. Just because of the green button on Brock. But you can see Tyrant's trying to push up, and I'm going to hit him once and just kind of back him up a little bit. I want to be aggro, so I don't know. I want to get some traps off, and I also want to hit the safe. I was kind of like feeling myself, and I just get green button, so it's kind of tough. And luckily I put that trap there, so Bobby is able to finish him off. Otherwise he could have done a ton of damage to our safe there. So you can see it's like relatively like stalemate. Zara's gonna do a good job. He is gonna take out, and unfortunately he does hit the trap there. I think he hit it intentionally. I probably, like, he knew it was there, but he probably just wanted to get rid of it. Ooh, Bobby almost gets Zulan. That was a good play. 16 HP though, and you know, I can get, if I get hit once, I just get green buttoned. And it's kind of unfortunate matchup. So I am going to hit Tyrant. I get him to one shot, but he does hit me. So he can just green button me now. And he also has super. But I do want to push up because we got a kill. So I'm trying to like push up just respectfully. But he does hit me. And I think I get... yeah, I get green buttoned. Green button auto aim. And Zara is going to trade some good shots. But I did manage to put some traps out. So that's why I was trying to push up, just to get some traps out there. Bobby's going to do a nice job dodging the curve on Zulan. And they're trying to get Tyrant to the safe, because Brock should be all the damage here. So I'm just trying my best to kind of like help out wherever I can. But I should be focusing primarily on Tyrant, because he is obviously the damage dealer. And Zulan is going to hit a really good shot on me, unfortunately. And it just looks really dangerous right now. So Tyrant's doing some good jukes. He's going to get his super off on safe. And our big lead just disappears like that. But we did manage to kill two of them there. So 15 seconds left. I hit Zulan once. He's really low. And they're just, they know Zara's our damage pretty much. So we're trying to get to safe. But it's hard because of the comp. And I do hit the trap. Unfortunately, I think if I don't hit that trap, I do manage to hit the safe once or twice. And we could have won the game. But I didn't know there was a trap there, and you know, we are gonna lose that one, unfortunately. All right, guys, so game number 2 on the Hot Zone set, which is set number 4. You know, last game, I mean, I think this whole series was just very, very close. Bobby's gonna do a curve early just to get some mid prio. And I kind of understand how to play the matchup a little better. That was my first time playing it, and it's weird because you, like, it just feels like this is the best comp to play, but we never practiced with this comp. So that was my first time playing it. And what I realized is I have to be more respectful and dodge the green button if possible. So I do manage to dodge it there, and you know, I'm gonna push up and I could go for some damage, but I think I'm just gonna try getting some traps out because, you know, I think it's way better, like, I stay alive and just hold position kinda and get some high traps out. So I can just kind of keep Tyrant at bay and just trust in Zara. He's been playing really good on Brock. Trust in Bobby as well. So my job is just defense, right? So that's what I'm talking about. Like, my team gets two good kills and we're all gonna get unsafe because of it, and we just do a ton of damage. So really well played for my team there. And unfortunately I do get green button there. I get hit by Corey once and the green button, it's really tough to deal with. So he is gonna hit my trap, and unfortunately Bobby won't be able to finish him off, I don't think. So we got to focus on Corey here. Zara's gonna hit a good shot. I do miss my shot on Tyrant when he's slow. It's kind of embarrassing. I did get marked though, so I'm gonna go down by like two shots there, and Tyrant is just gonna survive. And Bobby's gonna pinch over trying to keep Tyrant back, but kind of unlucky that I got marked there. Otherwise I think I live. And yeah, so it's pretty even right now. We do have the lead, but I think they are a bit in more like aggressive positions, right? So I'm gonna try marking Tyrant here, I think. Unfortunately I missed, but I do hit him, which keeps him back a little bit. And Corey is just gonna bounce shots on Bobby, and that's gonna be really annoying for his regen. So they do kind of take out, and you know, I was trying to keep the Brock at bay for a lot of this, and 20 HP feels really bad. Again, I've gotten him low so many times. But we're down by 1% with 15 seconds left. And, you know, I'm gonna stay up, and we just gotta hope we can get one shot off at this point. So Bobby is gonna get taken out, unfortunately. I'm gonna go for safe, but they both just hit me. I'm so close to getting my shots off. Corey does get a shot off either, but like both heist games by like 3-4%. So unlucky, but we do lose that, and it's tied 2-2 now. Alright guys, so we are on the fifth final map. And you know, we're gonna be playing Bell, Stu, and Dog. So the Stu gadget is really good for mid, so it's gonna enable me to put a lot more pressure. And you can see I'm hitting some really good shots already. I hit Corey and Tyrant once. I'm gonna hit Corey again and just try helping my lanes out, because I can move a lot easier in the Stu gadget, so it's kind of unfair. But Tyrant is gonna hit a shot on me, but I've definitely been hitting a lot more shots this game. Shout out to Stu gadget. And you can see Bobby does get taken down there, so I'm gonna see if I can pinch Zulin. But it is like a hard lane because I don't want to overextend, but I do get a good mark off on Tyrant. That's gonna be really big. And Zara's gonna go for it, but unfortunately Bobby goes down again. Zulin is a very good Rico, so I think it's just also a tough lane for Dog. Rico into Dog usually is kind of tough. I do get pinched there, and it's kind of hard because both my lanes are kind of losing this time. It's not their fault, they just have like bad matchups. Like the Dog counters Zara, right? And Zara almost takes out Tyrant there, but I'm gonna push up here, and I hit a trap unfortunately. I don't know, I didn't see the trap there. So the trap, it's as soon as they get the power up too. So we're down a good amount at this point. Corey's onto his second power up too. So Corey and Zulin have been playing really good. Tyrant's been doing good too. But their lanes have just been pretty dominant, and a lot of it's to the matchup. So I do take out Tyrant here. I do get marked, but I am gonna take out, I get them both really low, and I took out Tyrant, so that's really good. We can get some time in the zone. But Corey's just been playing really good on the Dog over in the corner. He almost takes out Zara, they almost trade. But now I am at a bit of a disadvantage just because he does have the power up and I don't. But I just gotta hit my shots, and I'm doing just that right now. And I do manage to take out Tyrant, and we can just kind of play through mid. So Corey does a really good job taking out Zara. But that power up is going to be kind of wasted too, because it's just over there. And none of his team have power ups right now because I did take out Tyrant the last play. So it's pretty even right now. We do have a slight lead, but I do really want to pinch Zulin and get him out of there so I don't have to worry about like just moving up. Luckily for me, he runs into both my traps. I don't even have to hit a shot. The traps do it for me. And now we can get some time in the mid. And this is what I've been wanting the whole game, just quality time alone in the middle where I'm not playing from like out of position. And you know, we're getting a pretty healthy lead, so as long as we don't all die here, you know, things are looking very good for us in game number one. And I'm gonna pinch Zulin, get him one shot. I'll manage to take Zulin out, and then I was hitting Tyrant too. Zara's gonna do a good job, take out Korai. And you know, it was kind of shaky, but I feel like this game I played pretty good, and I won mid pretty hard. And you know, we are able to kind of like play through mid because the lanes are really rough this game. It's not their fault, they were both countered, but I think I played pretty good this one. Alright guys, game number two. So the stew was just really rough that game. Zer was really good on stew, but that's just a hard counter, especially given like the matchup. But we go Penny this game, which can work really well. They went stew, and you can see like Zulan's gonna be on Bell, and Zulan is just very cracked at Bell, and he does have the movement thing, so it's definitely gonna be a lot harder for me at first. Last time I had the early game advantage because of it, but I do manage to hit him once or twice. But the movement speed is just really good. And unfortunately, the bounce there from the Bell shot just took me out. But Zara's getting some good shots, and he's pretty close to a Penny turret, so he's playing well on it. But Zulan is just kind of off to a really good start, and he's just hitting a lot of his shots right now. So in my opinion, Zulan's definitely one of the best players in NA right now. And you can see Bobby's doing a good job, though. And I'm hitting some shots back on Zulan, but unfortunately I'm marked, which is going to be really bad for me. And we do finally get some time in the zone, so but I am marked, so it's a big advantage for Zulan. So he did a really good job hitting a shot on me. It's going to change a lot of the interactions. So you know, I'm trying to get a mark on him. Unfortunately, I do miss it though, and he's going to catch me out of position. So Zulan is kind of carrying this game. He's kind of mid diffing me this one, honestly. But Zar is going to get his Penny turret out. Unfortunately, his walls are broken. And it's just not going to be as effective because the walls are broken. And, you know, but the Penny turret does get a really good kill there. And we're down by 40%. So it's not lost because it's the hot zone percentage goes up pretty fast if you stand in the zone. I don't know the exact amount, but it's a lot faster. So I do get a good mark on Zulan finally. He's going to get one on Bobby, but that should change a lot of the mid interactions. And now I have the advantage, but he is going to get that. So it kind of evens it out. And it's just kind of about hitting shots now. So Zar is going to go down, unfortunately. And I'm going to try just getting them low. So I get Zulan to one shot. Bobby's going to give me the power up, which is going to be really nice. And we still have a lot of time left. We can definitely win this game. And I'm going to get a pinch off on on Tyrant. And we are going to take him out. And I'm hitting some good shots on Zulan, but he's just done a very good job staying alive for most of this game, except for the Penny turret. The Penny turret was kind of goaded. Unfortunately, I do hit a trap there, and Zulan's going to be there to capitalize. I didn't know the trap was there, but my team's doing a really good job. So you can see we're catching up. It's really close now. We're only down by 10 ticks, and at this point, we have to like stay in the zone, like play really aggro. And you know, unfortunately, they do kind of collapse on us, and we got it really close. We almost had a really good comeback, but they are going to tie it up. So Zulan played out of his mind that game, I think. And, you know, gotta win the next one. Alright guys, game number three. So if we lose this, we get reverse sweep, which is really bad. But they've been playing really good the past few sets. Even the first two, they played really good. This time I do have the stew gadget at the start, which is going to make things a little more even. And Zulan's going to hit the first shot, but I think I do get him back here. So it's just kind of like weaving in and out and just being patient. So you can see we're just kind of taking turns. I'm going to go for his stew gadget. If I can get that, it's really huge. But unfortunately, I'm not able to. And I do get a good shot on Zulan. And you can see it's kind of even right now, a few percent up. But I'm going to hit him again. And I do manage to get the stew gadget, which is going to be really big. And I think I've hit more shots than him this game, so the stew gadget's definitely a big help. But overall, it's really even, and the lanes, like, it's just mirror, right? So it's literally whoever plays it better. I do miss my mark though, which is going to be really bad. I almost three tap him, but he does a really good dodge, and I'm getting bounced on, so I gotta back off here. And I think I can hit Corey, but I should just regen there, honestly. So he knows that I just... Oh, that's such a good mark, too. That mark changes this game so much. So I have to be a lot more careful. So my dogs got the power up first, but I'm marked right now. So I can still die really fast. I do almost get Zula in there. And Bobby's going to move up and get the turret. But I can get two tapped now that I'm marked. Even though I have like the extra HP from the dog thing, I get two tapped if I don't have my shield on. And he knows that, so he's kind of like waiting for me to overextend, hopefully hit a trap. But I know there's traps there, so I'm just trying to like get as much percent as I can and get a mark off. But unfortunately, I missed my mark again, so the mark makes such a big difference. We're both powered up now, and he's gonna hit me. Okay, so I do hit him twice there, but I'm getting bounced on from the turret, and it just really messes with my regen. So he's getting a lot more time in the zone than I am. And he two taps me there, which is so good. When that happened, I was like, oh my god, did I just like throw the game? But luckily, my lanes do come through pretty clutch, and Corey does hit my trap. So really good plays for my lanes there, and I'm able to get back in the zone with a power up. We're down a lot of percent now, but you know, it's definitely winnable, and Bobby's in a really good position. Zara's gonna be coming up with super, so I just gotta stay in the zone and not die. So we do take out Corey there. He does overextend a little bit, and we're all pinching Zuland. Zara's gotta stay up, but he does manage to go down, which is a little unfortunate. It's really close right now, but we are slowly catching up, getting the lead. We got a spread for the bounce shots. Zara is gonna go down again, unfortunately. But we do take out Corey here again. I get a good shot on him to finish him off. Now it's just up to me and Bobby against like Tyron and Zulin, and we're gonna hit our shots there. And just gotta not die to Corey. And we were so hyped when this was happening. We started like yelling. But it feels really good to finally win a final. We got close a few times. But, you know, we were able to bring it home. And this was one of the closest series that I've ever played in. So props to Tribe. They played really good. They always do. So it feels really good to win. But yeah, guys, that is going to be it for today's YouTube video. It's pretty long, so I'll probably end up cutting it in two videos or something, recording it or releasing it day after day. But yeah, guys, hope you enjoyed the games. I'll see you all soon. Peace.